You're ready for dinner, I see. Okay, bye.
Hello, Jennifer.
Okay.
Here
we go.
This is a spotlight group, and we're doing our first performance. I'm Ann.
I'm Heather.
I'm Kate.
And we're going to do a dance for you. It's dancing to Baby Baby by Anchor. We were starting to make it up in the bedroom, but then we had to do your lights right now.
See Heather?
Remember? Hmm? Oh, see, we were gonna do this in.
Katie, why so
high? Oh. That's what we thought about.
Wow, and then just, look, watch our trick. Watch me and Kate.
Hey, guys, watch what I can do to Kate.
No. Jennifer's gonna do it and Heather's gonna go under.
I go under.
Fine. Anne goes under.
No, Heather can go under.
No, you can.
No, because I'm gonna do something to Kate.
Fine.
I'm gonna do that to Kate.
Well, I'm gonna do that to Kate.
We both can do it.
What?
Go under.
Hurry!
It looks better in the bedroom.
Nuts?
Oh. I can do it better to Kate. Watch me.
Kate, you spit off!
Look, me and Kate have another.
This is Michelle, and this is Record, but we're not finished yet, and we just finished painting it yesterday, and that's for like our bright idea or whatever. It's like, see that guy is like broken.
Finishing up working on it, and as you can see, it was built by me and Chris, and we just finished attaching the rope to help you hold on. Thank you, Vanna. And okay, wait, get up.
Oh, look.
I know, I thought of that, but you could get your hands hurt. Okay, wait, get up. Okay, our logo is a light bulb with a smiley face inside for a good idea, and it's going to be fun to ride on. So you see, it took a long time, and I think we got on all the kinks. We're going to take a test drive right now. Okay, we are now going for the first drive in our push cart. So here we go. We're going to see how it works. So far, finally be finished.
Not sure if we're finished yet. We have to take a test to the thing. And then
are you willing to be the tester?
Yeah.
Okay, well, hop on. It is now 3:16, and for the second time, we're taking a test drive. And
first time took a test sit.
Wait, time out. Here we go. So far, so good. I can't see where I'm going, so.
Okay, don't move anywhere close.
Okay. Get up so we can put it in the street.
What? Oh. Why is this wheel so. Let me get up.
Why does it do this?
What is this?
not doing anything. Might as well just let it do that. Okay, you can get me on tape.
All her splendor.
It was?
Yeah.
Oops. Well, is it fun?
Wee.
I want to turn.
Okay. I don't know.
Wait till we get to your house. Come on.
It's kind of
creaky here.
This sun.
Go change direction.
Whoa.
Okay. There's a car coming.
Michelle did,
all right? Wait, let me ride.
This is the CKM3 go-kart. And it is.
Don't put the rope on the
Let
window.
Me try, Michelle.
Let's see, Michelle. You better not break those
Michelle.
Wheels.
Huh?
Hey, it's not yours.
Woo-wee.
If we say you can.
Neat. Oh, let's see.
Nice.
Come on, y'all. Be nice. Look at this nice constructed go-kart.
Hey.
It turns.
Real creaky and all.
Gee, it goes a lot faster with Chris on. Self-propel.
All
right. Michelle, can I please?
We're going to see how fast this thing can really go. Pretty smart.
Well, no, Ann, we paid for this whole thing. Hey, we paid for this whole thing out of our own money.
Why don't you make it so that they can pay for one ride at a time?
Because.
They can see if they want, what if they don't like it? And they'll never want to ride it again, Michelle?
They will, believe me.
You don't know.
Yes, I do know.
No, you don't.
Someday when I'm not here, they're gonna get it out and they're gonna want to ride it.
I'll pay her, but I don't have any money yet.
Well, you can give me an IOU.
I'll give you an IOU.
Me and Chris need to go calculate up how much the total is, and we're going to divide it by the amount of people up here.
But that's it. I don't have to pay any of that.
They're debating about who should pay for this go-kart. Michelle and Chris paid for it, but everybody wants to ride it. So they're going to charge them for rides. And Daddy's gonna
you don't have to pay for the ride of
settle this, huh?
I already paid $1.
Guys, how come
you're not letting us
ride?
Michelle, how much did this vehicle end up costing?
Me and Chris are gonna go calculate up the receipts and see how much.
Plus, the two of the wheels are from my bike.
No, it's from my bike, darling.
It was mine.
It was my bike.
That no, you got that white bike.
That one was from mine.
Mom said.
I did the whole thing. I think y'all ought to pay me.
Hey, Al.
Jennifer.
What are you doing, little boy? You're so cute, Al. You're so cute.
Alex got a nice bed of moss. He's so cute. He is so cute.
Hi, it's near, it's, okay.
I'm gonna tell you about this tree. It's a mint tree, and we put hearts on it, and they say things from the Bible, and I'm gonna read you about two. And this one says, cast all your cares upon Jesus because Jesus cares for you. And that's 1 Peter 5:7. And this one says, God demonstrated his love for us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And that's Romans 5:8. And here's Al trying to tear apart the beads.
Hold on. Mama, it says low light. Hey, Mom. Is Mama there?
No.
Jen, it says low light. What did?
Okay, well, and see, we have 40 hearts for 40 days of Lent, and we're going to hang them all up on the tree, and at the last day of Lent, we'll have 40 hearts on the tree, and on each heart, we're going to put a Bible scripture or verse. And everyone writes 8 of them. And Al likes our trees.
That's very nice tree. Mom did it all by herself. And us kids did some Bible verses. We looked them up in the Bible. And we got some new curtains. Got some over here
and
too.
Mom put these. Okay, well, I guess we have to go now. Signing off. Bye.
Bye.
Hiccup, sorry.
Okay.
We're at Moore Park. Yesterday, Chris's team played two games. They won one, lost one. The one they won, Chris scored the winning goal, and they won 1-0. We're warming up for a 7:30 game at Moore Park. It's a beautiful, beautiful Sunday morning. Gorgeous Sunday morning. There's the referee's tent at Moore Park. Yesterday, Chris's games were at Neyland, and he spent all day at Neyland. Four games reffing and two games played. There's the referees getting ready for our 7:30 game. And who have we here?
Hi, honey.
How you doing?
It's a beautiful morning.
Isn't it gorgeous?
For a soccer game. Go, Chris.
Pre-game preparation going on. Okay, we're getting ready to play. Gentlemen shaking of the hand. Chris is playing right forward in this game. We're almost ready for the beginning. There's the team we're playing.
Oh, nice try, John.
Oh, John DeClue almost scored a goal in. How did that not go in?
Come on, Matt. He's had two. He should have two.
I thought it was in the goal in Chris.
Yeah, but when Matt was right there, he should have had.
Here's Chris getting ready for a corner.
Get up. Nice shirt.
It's still in. All right, got our goal. Way to go, John.
Okay, honey.
Doing what you love to do.
Stop. Oh, hot dog truck.
Yeah, we got a lot of goodies here being sold. It's halftime. It's 1-1 now, the score. Come on. That's it. Way to go, Chris. All right, good score. Mark's got a game going there. Horses in battle. Hey, Mark. Jeez. Way to go. Beautiful, Matt.
Good work.
Good score, John.
Nice setup.
Way to go. Nice pad. Nice pad, Matt. Good team workout.
Good pass, Matt.
I can hit the head, Mark.
Go, Matt.
Go. Get ready, Ben. Get ready.
Watch it over here. Watch it over here.
Jane's a fullback when horses in battle. All right, they won the game.
Good game, guys. Good game. Good game, fellas. Good luck.
Good game. Good game.
We'll have a rematch in the season, I guess.
Good game, guys. Where to play? Where to play?
I'm not going to say we're number one because we're not.
That's all right.
So, appropriate Dr. Pepper for the Dr. Pepper Cajun Cup.
Yep.
Hey, bring on the hot shots, man.
Yes, where's some donuts?
Now what?
Yes, Christopher Lennon in this game. He's checking the player passes.
Hello, we're here. Just got the kids from school and we took them to the Holidome. And we're gonna celebrate Jennifer's 12th birthday. We got a cookie cake. Where's the birthday girl?
There's the birthday girl.
How's it feel to be here at the hotel for your birthday? Celebrating it a few days late. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Ooh, look at these presents. Lucky little girl, I think, huh?
Lucky and big girl. Have,
yeah, big girl. And we're having the Mannings come over, and their room is going to be right next to ours.
Where'd you get that from?
Okay, and Sherry's going to be coming by. Your cousin Sherry.
Hey, I found out where
the found the ice. Got the ice?
Yay.
All right.
Come get the cake.
I found out.
Chris is checking out the lobby, looking at the swimming pool and the video games.
Have a look. Is this the wrapping paper?
Happy 12th birthday, Jennifer. Kind of got a little messed up in the car driving here, but it's going to be good. It's fresh. They just baked it. Yum, yum. See ya.
Bye.
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 Ah, look at this wrapping paper. It's comics. I got that because you knew you loved to read the comics, Jennifer.
Okay, come on. Let me read one.
A lot closer.
This is a nice hotel.
Look who's here. Thank you for... They're here for Ben's basketball tournament. So they're going to be going to Abbeville tonight.
Well, this is a great unexpected surprise.
That's okay. I took the wrong cup.
Just wash it.
And I'm getting over a cold, too.
Boy. Where is Jamie? James. There he is. And Crisco.
Oh God, I love these.
All right. How you doing?
Taza.
See your shirt. No parties in hell. Just one big barbecue, and you don't want to be invited. Hey girls, we had fun.
Birthday girl, we're at Holiday Inn, and it's about 7 o'clock. How y'all doing, girls?
rather than tea. Here's Helen. She just got braces. How do you like them? Do you like them? Here's Chris again. Okay, I'll get other people. You might be getting bored.
Good popcorn.
Here's Mom chomping down popcorn.
Waiting for the pizza.
Here's Heather chomping down popcorn. Here's Kate chomping down popcorn. Here's Miss Pat chomping down popcorn.
Get you in the mirror.
Here's me in the mirror.
53. I just opened up.
Happy birthday.
Oh, you're supposed to draw your presents.
In my
house. Oh, yeah.
I gotta get it this time. Never heard of it.
Presents. Bye. Julian. Oops. Wait.
Yep,
here's
okay.
My brush.
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna take a bite at Laura.
Okay. I forgot.
Don't be too long,
save
precious.
For the party.
Okay, I have to save some for the party.
That's my one and only daughter. The most important person in the world.
Lara.
Sayonara.
So you want to squeeze on my crew's arm?
Hey, what's this about that thing?
For today's pick-up choice,
how do
you want to die? I can throw you out the window.
Yeah,
you want me to
light
the candles?
I want you to video tape.
I'm
just
waiting.
You
can find out
like getting ready to sing.
Jennifer.
Oh, boy.
Can you put this on that thing?
Can you get Michelle with me, sirs?
Oh,
Debbie.
It's
getting close to us.
I'm starting to really look.
Thank you. If you don't hold it in an upright angle, it won't burn the match so fast.
Oh, one more. One more. One more, I'll put the glasses on.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jennifer. Happy birthday to you.
And many more.
All right. Way to go.
Thank you.
Happy birthday
to me.
It's all in the lights.
Thanks,
I want. No,
that is
back
at any time.
Okay, let's open this, too. Jennifer. Open this.
You may push it.
It's always a problem.
Jennifer just got the gold card.
This is from me.
I
can
Thank you.
Go to the office.
Jen, here's my present.
So
you don't have to read it out loud.
Thank you.
Toothpaste.
It's toothpaste.
She wanted
toothpaste.
She wanted the white.
No, I didn't.
Oh. It makes you cheaper.
This is for
Mel,
too.
I
expect.
Ah, it's not
sugar.
I got it.
Let me say, Jennifer.
I know. This is the only time she'll get real gum.
She'll probably see
yeah.
Cotton candy and watermelon.
That'll last about 2 minutes, right?
Yeah,
Kate's
present is in the bag, so
I'm
too.
Okay. Happy birthday, sweet. I wonder why it's 12.
Why is it 12?
Thank you. Thank you, Dad.
Can I have a hug too?
Great, I said you're one music video.
You said way more. So now y'all can copy everything he says.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a videotape.
Yeah, Amy Grant music video.
Is that for Mom?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You can play it in 5 weeks.
Thank you.
What does that mean? I want that shirt.
It'll be my own.
That's not shirt.
Thank you. $2.
Nice for you, Jenna.
Mom, you bought that a long time ago.
Look at it, Jen.
Michelle.
It's pretty cool. Look at the back. The back has that little pull.
The little clipper thing?
Yeah, the little clipper thing. Uh-huh.
Thank you. I showed Mom.
Look, the color is so pretty on you.
Jennifer, I showed Mom that.
Yeah, have it picked it up.
Thanks.
Magic doll.
Yeah,
I know it.
Thank you. What is it?
Magic
doll. It's a flower. It's a rose.
The puzzle?
It's a rose.
See, ours? No, it'll show you.
Oh, that's what you
what
got
it?
Her?
You kind of got to get alert.
I thought you got her. What?
A cute. You have to roll up the end, kind of, in the back. Yeah. Does it fit?
Leave this. The tag on. You'd be like a bag lady.
You like many times.
Thanks.
Thanks, Dad. Oh, yeah, so you won't have to worry the washer all the time.
But yeah, it might be pretty.
That'll look pretty with those jeans and
it'll
hats,
look pretty.
Too.
Look, yeah. Oh,
but
look,
that matches
the jeans
your flower.
And the hat.
And this.
Yeah. Thank you.
And we got Yuna Kima.
It's ready for her look.
And
that's
what's
from Kate.
That?
That's from Kate. That's the kind you wanted? Oh, that was fun.
Kind of torn.
Well, that's why.
I see that bright color. I
yeah, that red tag. I thought I took them off.
What?
I have 10 red
tags. I don't want
to
hear
it.
So?
We had that game.
Gosh, you better erase that.
Oh, Jennifer.
She's 12 years old now, and she's face washing with Noxzema. Yay, Jennifer.
Woohoo.
Hey, Jennifer.
Look at these good girls playing Monopoly Junior. And let's see what time is it. Well, it's really 11:52. It's still very late, girls. Getting ready for bed.
Do you know numbers?
1, 2, 3, 4.
I got it. Oh, yeah, I know that.
I know that.
Me and...
Good, honey.
No.
It's been a wonderful night.
Yeah, it's been wonderful.
Since we're here. Oh, here we are with the Cousins and the Mannings. Thank you.
fight a lot.
Very good, Michelle.
See, when I came in...
Well, keep doing it. You do a song. Do that again.
I've done this part, I'll show you. Okay, drop down here.
Drop? Oh yeah, you have to drop.
You have
to. Like going, this thing, you have to blow it up or something.
Yeah, yeah. Not yet. Alright, just jump over these spikes. Like,
how are you going to jump over?
Oh!
Jump over.
All this guy is going to step off.
I just think she wants to see how many seconds.
Watch this, watch this, watch when the ball goes out and watch the delay on the blow and the whistle, watch this. At the time it probably hit the line, the referee didn't blow the whistle immediately, he waited till after. It was a delayed reaction. Look at Ben, Ben's celebrating. All right, you gotta leave full, Ben's celebrating, but the referee hasn't blown the whistle yet.
No, he still has,
Ben, but now his hand goes up. You know what I'm saying? Ben's sitting there going like this, and then the referee goes what? Blows the whistle and raises his hand.
Ben has his fingers up.
Ben.
Two seconds.
It should be two instead of
one. Yeah. Yes, but the same referee who's going to be dancing on the sideline with his little nigger jig.
Look, 2 seconds left and they called
it game. And the
referee
said 1 second.
No, it
does. They called it game.
He wants to be sure. He wants to know the time didn't run out.
But the referee.
He knew there was 2 seconds left.
Now what? What's going on?
He can get it.
Now, see what I'm saying? Ben's like celebrating, but the referee didn't blow the whistle when he hit the line. The ball should have been blown dead when he hit the line, not after he stepped out of bounds with it.
Yeah.
Watch again. Watch when the ball hits the line. See what I'm talking about? The referee was slow on the whistle. Hold up. Well, stop, stop, stop. And now Ben told us after it was supposed to go to him up at the top of the key. Or to Matt, rewind.
I know, if Ben and Matt can get it.
All right, Matt is number, stop, play, slow motion, whatever. Alright, let's see if we can find Matt and show y'all who Matt is.
See, Ben still got hope for this kid.
Oh, Ben never gives up. And then Ben knows he can make it.
He does give up sometimes.
He does give up sometimes.
No, but Ben knows, like this game.
Ben thinks he...
I tell you, this was a pressure. He tried some pressure.
Alright, Matt is number... Matt is the little guy with the dark hair. I think he's number 10 or so. That basketball is won by being the tough guy.
Oh, wow. They lost by 3 points in the final.
5-7-2.
I'm not sure. Was that the five?
We're going to get a real basketball game going here. Yeah, they're all here, ready to go.
So that one's a little higher than what he's really used to. Melissa, wait, is it Michelle or Melissa? Michelle, she plays on the 10-foot goals. On this high.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a regular
price point. Yeah, high speed. Yeah. See, Ben's getting 7th grade, so.
Whoa!
Alright.
So is it everybody gets Jerry?
I'm trying to figure out who's a winner.
That's what I heard it was yesterday.
Thank you.
It was 15 to 2.
He was
by himself.
You're kidding.
It was him against everybody.
My husband's more. Does your husband like to play?
He doesn't much.
Huh?
He likes to, but he doesn't much.
I didn't talk.
We'll see you on the tape.
Up, Chris.
Michelle looks good. She looks strong.
Yeah. Whoa! Race
of
6 miles, Trudy.
Oh. When is that going to be?
Yeah, I think the end of April, maybe. Yeah. All right. Come on, Chris.
I'm trying to figure out who's on whose team.
It looks like Chris, Ben, Michelle, and Mike.
On the same. Jerry and Keith and
who's Mike's your husband?
Yeah. Right.
Chris and
Alan's on the other team. Oh. Chris, guess Jerry's on the other team too. Yes, Jen!
Almost!
Well, wait, are there 9 people out there? One team's got an extra person. Oh, I see on the TV when you can play.
Oh, I thought maybe you could tape it without the sound.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
But it's exciting with all the.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. I don't know.
Yeah, well, when you're right there on the camera, but all the other screaming and all, you know, it adds to the excitement. But yeah, I do sound a little distracted sometimes.
Oh, I love the block though. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. They hit the rim, Mike.
Yeah, record us on the tape.
Go!
Come on, Chunky. 30 up.
There you go.
Really 6:43. Off to school. Okay, we're getting ready for the Easter egg hunt. They each find 5 eggs. Go!
Hey.
Hey, Daddy's home. Just in time, Jennifer. And Heather. Hi, honey. They're looking for Easter eggs.
How you doing?
Daddy just got back from golfing.
Hello.
Hi, he's on vacation this week. Give me a kiss. Let's see. Where are they? See, there's one egg that has a dollar bill in it. I hit him good. They're hidden down in bushes. You gotta look. I hope I remember where I hid all of these. Like a copper. I just gotta feed copper.
How many did you find, Heather? How many did Chris find?
How many did you find?
One.
I
found one.
I see one.
Y'all gotta look good. Chris, how many do you have? She got all 5. Let's see which ones are in there. I don't know if that's the golden egg in there or not. We're going to open them when they're all found. All right, you got all 5. Yay. All right. All 5. Jennifer's looking for one more egg. She's warm. You just warm. Jennifer's getting really hot.
I need some water.
She's gonna burn up pretty soon.
Jen, you might wanna blow the monkey grass.
Watch out, she's gonna really get hot.
Ah, look what I dug up.
A golf ball? No, we don't want a golf ball. We need an Easter egg. You got it? All right, yay. Hey, girls and boy. Y'all can open up your loot.
Penny.
There's $1 bill, four quarters, four nickels. Dimes, four nickels, and five pennies.
Dollar, yes!
Yes!
I have a quarter, two dimes, a nickel, and a dollar.
Wow, you did good.
I have two pennies.
There's three more. You said you wouldn't get anything.
Come on.
I got a dollar.
We're
gonna have
fun.
Got $2, I got a nickel, and I got
so far, I got two pennies.
Heather, you said you would be happy.
I'm happy. The next one's a quarter of it. Okay, let me add a
nickel.
I got about all the quarters.
You got all the quarters?
He got
y'all
three
add
quarters.
Up and tell me what y'all have.
Chris has three quarters because I got no quarters. I got one quarter.
How much you have, son?
Not.
No, it isn't.
Oh, you still have another?
81 cents.
No, I already saw this movie.
How much you have, Heather? Not finished counting, huh?
I didn't start.
She did open
them. How about you have, Jennifer?
25, 35, 45.
$0.22.
Some candies in there too.
$1.50.
Good. Okay, in a little while we're gonna dye Easter eggs.
I wonder how it was last night.
Jennifer said it was nice.
It
Jennifer,
was nice.
Tell Miss Betty about last night.
It was nice, honey. They had as many people.
I think we're going to go tonight.
I've never been to
pretty.
One.
I haven't either. Not for the vigil with the big mass, you know, with the fire and all that.
I never expected to be done early.
Hi.
Hey.
Aren't those beautiful eggs?
That's mine. And that's mine.
Show them the one I did.
Mom did that one.
It says, God bless the U.S.
God bless the U.S.
S. How you coming, Heather? She's painting on her egg.
And I'm whackering.
Yeah. They sure look pretty.
Heather, see what you got. Look what you got.
Peanut butter.
You got a book sack purse?
Yes, I did.
Chris get.
He got a Les Miserables shirt, but be quiet. See the little face of the, of, what's that girl's name?
I don't know. Look at that guy. I got a book sack purse too. So nice. Let's see. Oh, gotta be quiet because mom and dad are still sleeping. It's 8:37 around night. My set doesn't start till 9:37. What?
Robin eggs.
Yum.
They gave us Whoppers. I mean, Milk Duds and Whopper. They're almost the same thing.
Nuh-uh.
No, they're not. No, they're not.
I said they're not the same thing.
I know.
Shoot. It's a little light. And Jen, come turn this light on.
Don't say shoot.
Jen, can you turn the slide on right here?
This is chocolate, I mean,
Jen, it's blinking on and off the light. Go turn the light on.
They gave us a lot of sour heads. Warheads.
Go turn.
Are you taping?
That light, yes. Check this one. And skip.
You should turn this off.
Look!
What?
None of us are ups.
They get that from them.
No, it's from the Easter Bunny.
Oh, they got something. They got Werther's. And the Easter Bunny gave them like his ups too.
I didn't say that. Well, we tried to get Chris up, but he wouldn't. Well, we did get him up. She said he won't come in when sister's asleep until mom and dad come. So, well, bye for now. Back. Slowly. This room said to go. Christopher. Well, let's leave him alone. Yeah, I told you, get up.
Al's by the ferns over there. He's going to chase
you
a squirrel.
See the squirrel off the tree coming
look,
down?
No, where's the squirrel?
He was looking over
you
me.
See the squirrel coming down?
I see Al. Oh.
Yeah, I saw the squirrel.
There he is. See the squirrel sticking out?
No. Where's the squirrel?
Right by the chair.
Look at the squirrel at the top.
Al can get up.
Here comes the squirrel. Al can jump up there. That's right.
Al's hiding.
Al, the squirrel is playing with him. Happy Easter, Al.
2 years
Al's
ago.
An Easter cat. We got Al 2 years ago.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. We got you for Easter, Al, 2 years ago. Yeah, you're a good kid, cat. You got big. Is that good?
Look, y'all.
Here is for you. So, Heather, thanks for the other presents in the pack.
Smack, smack, smack. Yum, yum, yum. I love you. She did that last night.
From the Easter Bunny.
The bunny logo.
Heather. What? What are you laughing at?
What?
What Mom and Daddy got? Yay, we got the movie Les Miserables, honey.
Did I brush my hair yet?
We just had the TV here just because for movies. Just
no, not now. Not now.
I'm watching it.
All right,
turn it
on. No. Now?
Isn't
he coming in?
He took it to his room.
Took what?
His Easter basket.
Oh, no.
Surveying the site of some ancient ruins, two young archaeologists, Derek and Margot, and their nomad friend, Moki, find themselves trapped and sinking in a whirlpool of sand. And when the dust settles, they stare up in awe at a vast chamber filled with giant relics and artifacts from another civilization. And there, at the far end of the cavern, a door with a strange inscription. All who enter these portals pass through time.
Jen, we were watching this movie, and one of these kind of movies at the library, and I think I saw this one.
They all start the same. They all start like that.
If it's whenever he loses his scrolls. Yeah, this is it.
No, they all start.
They don't.
Well, at least we're lost in someplace pretty.
Yeah, we saw this one.
And friendly.
But someone's gonna lose his scrolls.
Hey, come back! Huh? Where did this come from? And what is it?
It's a scroll someone's been writing on.
It rolled down from up there.
Come on, we'll take it back.
Yeah, and maybe that guy up there will tell us where we are.
And when we are.
And the crowd said,
"Hey, mister, we found your..." Whoa!
Huh?
There! No, here!
Got it! Look! There's another!
We found your scroll.
We call him Moki, but you can just call him Little Mr. Graceful.
I'm sorry, but everything's okay now, right?
Yes, Moki. Thank you. Please, come and sit. I'm Derek, and this is Margot. My name is Mark. You had me worried. These notes are from my talks with Peter himself. My whole gospel is based on them.
Your gospel?
Mark, when you say Peter, do you mean Saint Peter?
Well, he was a fisherman like his brother Andrew, and he was there, a witness. And yes, he was a saint.
You mean what you're writing? Your gospel? Those scrolls? Well, are you writing the story of the life and teachings of Jesus Christ?
Yes. I don't know as anyone has written it yet, and his story's got to be told. I was just writing about his betrayal, his death, and resurrection.
The story of Easter?
That's why I came here to the Garden of Gethsemane, for inspiration.
Here? This is Gethsemane? The garden where Jesus prayed the night before he...
Yes, over there is Jerusalem. It's almost exactly as it was about 35 years ago when it all happened.
Mark, will you read some of what you're writing, please?
It was on a beautiful, bright Sunday morning when Jesus sent two of his disciples for the donkey, a special donkey he would ride into the city of Jerusalem that day.
There it is, just where he said we'd find it.
Well, what did you expect, James? That Jesus would be right about everything else and wrong about a donkey?
Wait a minute. What are you doing untying that colt?
Andrew, tell them what Jesus said to answer if we were challenged.
The master has need of it.
Oh, well, take him then. But I should warn you, that donkey's special. He's never been ridden.
Never even been sat on.
We know.
I didn't know if Jesus used a donkey that had never been used before.
As Jesus approached Jerusalem, the city seemed to come alive with expectation. Crowds gathered in the streets and grew larger and larger.
Look!
Here he comes!
Oh, yes, Jerry!
What is it? What's going on? Who's coming?
Most of it.
It's the prophet Jesus!
Jesus of Nazareth, the miracle worker. He turned water into wine.
And fed thousands with only a few fish and a few loaves of bread.
Some say he's the Son of God.
The Son of God.
Blessed be the King that comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven.
Glory in the highest.
Put him down. Yeah. I stopped for a while.
Offended the house of God. Is it not written, my house shall be called a house of prayer for all nations, but you have made it a den of thieves.
Right, Caiaphas?
Were we not right to warn you of him, O noble high priest?
The people are moved by his new ideas.
Blasphemous ideas that threaten all of us.
His followers multiply day by day.
We must do something.
We can't. Not now. After the Passover has been celebrated, we'll see what happens.
Lord Jesus, it's not a rumor any longer. The priests have issued a commandment for anyone who knows where you are to report it. And they'll be well paid. You must leave at once, Lord.
Let's go!
Hurry,
let's
my
go.
Lord!
Hurry, come, Jesus!
Please.
Hurry now!
No, I will stay and join in a Passover Seder here in Jerusalem.
Jesus,
you may do what you will.
We will stay and celebrate the
he
Passover with
Jesus.
You. All of us.
Three times, and then he hung himself.
The Passover is Palm
And I'll tell you how to find a safe place for the dinner.
Around that, but it was long before the death of Christ.
Palm Sunday is
this is just a passion. This is just, yeah, but that's just a, like a remembrance of the Passover. They're celebrating the feast of the Passover, which happened in the Old Testament, but they celebrated it every year. But they celebrated it right
before. When they met a man bearing a pitcher of water to follow him.
Is this Palm Sunday or is this?
No, they already had Palm Sunday.
Is this the Easter one?
Yeah. This is like.
So this is between Palm Sunday and.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, Holy Thursday. Holy Thursday is. Yeah. This is Holy Thursday.
What's Holy Thursday?
This is Holy
Whatever
Thursday.
Whatever house
they
he entered,
the Last Supper
they were to
the
say to the man of the
they
house.
They were celebrating
the
feast of the
asked,
Passover.
Where is the guest
the
room
Supper?
Where I shall celebrate the Passover with my disciples? Jesus said he would show them a large upper room furnished and prepared.
See, this the Last Supper is the first.
And all was as he had said. So in the evening, Jesus came into the city with his 12 disciples, and they sat and ate.
And everything was exactly as Jesus said it would be.
So, here we are.
Ah, oh, safe and sound.
These are the apostles?
Shh, yeah. The master would speak. One of you will betray me.
Judas.
No, not I. Never.
The one who dips his bread in the...
Is it I?
The one
is
who it dips I? Is it I? Is it I? Is it I?
The one who dips
is
his bread.
Is it I?
The
is it
one
I?
Who
is it I?
Who
is
he
it
dips
I?
His bread and milk and
it
gives
is
it to something like that.
One of you 12 who dips bread into the bowl with me. Take. Eat. This is my body. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. I will drink no more of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God.
That's the first Eucharist, first time they celebrate it.
Amen.
But
you were tired. Derek and Margot told me you've traveled far.
That's the truth for sure.
Well then, Moki, you're no worse than the Apostle Peter himself. He fell asleep too, right here in this same garden, when he was supposed to be keeping watch over Jesus.
He did?
Yes. But when Jesus returned from his prayers and woke him, Jesus was gentle with him. Oh, Peter, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. I'm sorry, Master, Enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. No, Lord.
Sal. You said he'd be here. Where is he?
In the garden. Follow me.
Judas told them that he's there.
Lead him off safely.
Yes, yes, get on with it.
I thought betraying means like saying you don't know him.
No, that's a
my
denial.
My betrayer comes.
Huh?
That's denial.
Master! Master!
He knows that he's betraying you.
Judas!
Take him!
You betray me
stand
with a kiss.
Stand back! Ah! No, Peter!
Put your sword away.
He cut off
his
ear.
He who lives by the sword dies by the sword. Don't you know
that
I could ask God for 12 legions of angels and they'd come and save me? But how
That's what
then
they
could
said.
The scriptures be fulfilled?
Take down this.
Take him to the high priest for trial.
What it didn't show is that Jesus healed his ear.
Yeah, he put it back.
And also he said, Judas, you betray me with a kiss.
Speak! Speak! Answer the charges against you! Say something! Bring in another witness.
Another false witness?
Yes, I heard the prisoner clearly say he'd destroy the temple we built with our own hands. And in 3 days, he put up another made without hands.
What does that mean, Dad?
Well,
what is Jesus talking about?
What say you to that?
When he said that.
I have one more question which I know you must answer. Are you Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?
You said it.
I am. And you shall see me sitting on the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven.
Oh, I thought you said it. You said it. Yeah.
Blasphemy! We need no further witnesses. What say you?
Get out of here!
For the blasphemer!
They just found him guilty. Sentenced to death.
Who?
Jesus, the prophet. You know, you were one of those who followed him, weren't you?
No. I don't know him at all.
He's denying.
Sure, I saw you leading him into the city last Sunday.
You've got me confused with someone else. I've never even seen the man. Excuse me.
Hold! Sure, you're one of them. They all speak with
me. How about Judas did that?
A few. I've told you
Judas
all.
Judas betrayed him.
I don't know him.
Right.
Let me pass.
But he said he's sorry, but Judas hung himself.
Truly, I say to you,
he said he wasn't the one who did
it. Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
Twice.
Oh, the poor man.
Yes, he had indeed done the unthinkable, exactly as Jesus had foreseen.
But the others all ran away. I wouldn't have done that.
Ah, the betrayer. Don't tell me you've come for more money. You won't get it.
No. I have sinned and betrayed innocent blood.
Innocent? Ah! You should have known. How much was it we paid him exactly? Just 30 pieces of silver. Well, you got yours, Judas.
Take it. Take all of it. The money is cursed. The man known as Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor of Jerusalem, was the only man who could order the death sentence to be carried out. He could also prevent it. The earthly life of Jesus was in his very weak hands.
So, tell me, are you the king of the Jews?
You have said it.
Look here, fellow, do you understand what they're charging you with? How am I to decide what to do with you? Pilate! Pilate! Where is he? Pilate! That's those jealous priests who condemned you. But the people like you. Your entrance into the city on Sunday was quite a triumph, I hear. Wait a moment.
Pilate had an idea. Each year at Passover, it was the practice to release one prisoner. He would give the crowd a choice. Release Jesus or a murderer named Barabbas.
I wouldn't want a murderer.
Pilate was certain the crowd would choose Jesus. He was wrong.
Tell him, Barabbas. We want Barabbas.
Yes,
Barabbas.
That's not fair. They showed him silver coins.
They
bribed him. They bribed him with coins.
Well, I wash my hands of the whole thing.
He could have stopped it. Why didn't he?
He wanted to satisfy the...
No.
They do.
Who wants his robe?
Well, let's pray for it. It's mine.
My God. My God.
Why have you forsaken me?
Doesn't he get a drink and then he says that?
They don't show everything.
Yeah, they give him a Viagra. Yeah, they skipped him some points.
Truly, like, this man was the Son of God.
Even now, his people are putting his body in a tomb.
We're certain in the dead of night, they'll steal it out and claim he's fulfilled his promise.
His promise to rise from the dead within 3 days.
So?
If they stole the body and told the people he rose from the dead, that deception would be worse than the first.
We've got to prevent them from getting anywhere near him.
Oh, I see. Very well. You may have your guards.
Was he bad?
Seal the tomb.
He wanted...
Angel of the Lord has rolled away the stone. Your Jesus, who was crucified, is not here. He is risen. Look! See the place where they laid him.
Oh, I see. I see.
For 40 days thereafter, he presented himself to many people throughout Judea.
I'm not shy.
John's Cathedral.
Thank you. humanity, for your love, for your care, and for being with us during this past school year. We also ask you to be with us in a special way this morning, so that we may realize that whether or not we receive an award, we are all special.
The body of Christ, through our example, and so we commend these recipients. We now award these awards to, and let their example of us encourage us to draw closer to Christ.
The winners are, for this year, the fourth hour, Giselle Luquet.
We, in your opinion, and that of the faculty, has shown some of the great qualities of this great Greek saint. I'm very happy to call for Stephen Anthony Potier to receive this award.
Nick Luther, Barrett Landon. Janae Bouquet. Jennifer Thorpe. And Giselle Bouquet.
Christopher's last school bus ride in his life. That's it. There he is. Last ride of his life. The mailman's congratulating Chris. There he is. How was it? The last day of school, eighth grade. Your last school bus ride in your life. Never again have to ride a school bus, son. All right. Hey, congratulations, Christopher. Hey, look, we got you. Little Caesar's pizza to celebrate this special day. What you want today? Day Chris. I got 6 awards today. He was recognized during the honors. And they had even more awards after we left. So show us what you got. What are they? Come on. Let's go one by one, okay. Certificate. of participation for cross country. Yay, as a cross country and track team member.
For cross country and track. That's for language arts Olympiad. That's for being an Eye of the Tiger newspaper. That's for passing the computer literacy credit exam, because I don't have to take it next year.
He's already got a high school credit in computers.
Or having over 85 on my CAT or SAT.
Presidential Award for Outstanding Academic Achievement, signed by Bill Clinton.
And that's for physical fitness.
Very good. 6 nice awards. Now, guess what? Got some good news. You never again have to wear that uniform.
You should be happy you have no more you did.
Oh, this is so exciting.
8th grade graduation. We're at St. John's Cathedral. Hey, y'all. Where y'all going?
Oh,
Christopher Keith Crossguard. Barrett Campbell Landing. Jonas Matthias Landry. Joshua George Landry. Stephen Earl Landry. Stephen.
Take a picture, okay? Circle around that. I'll check. Go on, Chris. All the way around. Take a picture.
Let's go.
Go.
Not good. Not good. Not good. Not good.